Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus...
All right, I want to welcome everybody to this NJCAA Region 21 contest with the visiting North Country Community College Saints from New York and your Bristol Community College Bayhawks as we broadcast this contest here from Bishop Connolly High School next to the beautiful campus of Bristol Community College. I'm David Cardoza on the play-by-play. Alongside with me is none other than the Portuguese cowboy himself, Mr. Craig Salvador. Craig, how's it going?
It's going pretty good, Dave. Great to be back here to enjoy some Bristol Bayhawks basketball. Rosensteel, wow, quick out the gate.
Yes, sir. North Country, this was like a spur of the moment, just and that basket is scored by North Country, and they get on the board first.
Yeah, this was a last-minute scheduling kind of game. Both of us only heard about this the other day, I believe.
Yeah, this game just kind of popped up on the schedule. Non-conference matchup, not a Region 21 matchup. And just like that, out the gate, 4-0 North Country.
Yeah, one thing about North Country we're seeing right now is their jerseys are really hard to read. Got that dark green, that dark green, dark black. I can see you squinting trying to see who scored that.
Yes.
Not a good shot there either.
I was gonna say, not a good uniform design. The dark green on the black uniforms. Not a good look.
Nope, not a good design.
Got to see the numbers.
Nope.
So anyway, BCC coming off a huge victory on Tuesday night, Craig. You missed it, 100-130. BCC was that shot's going to be off by Romeria Tucker. Bringing it up the other way is Misha Edwards.
Misha Edwards wanted a call and looked like she got it. It's a foul on number five.
Yeah, they're going to call a foul on. They're going to call a reach in on Romeria Tucker. But BCC had 100 points scored in their last game on Tuesday after losing their first game after the Christmas break. And BCC's seen, you know, a few girls get into double figures. Megan Paris was huge in that game, Misha Edwards. And Shannon Rodensteel was on the bench most of the game in foul trouble. Katia Luna had seven threes. She was unbelievable from the arc. So, and it looks like we have a technical foul here.
You're talking about the big win. That's good to see, especially then coming back and really just playing the way they were playing before the break. Like I said, Megan Parrish, Shamisa Edwards being big contributors, Rosensteel being contributing, but also been in foul trouble a lot.
Yeah, that's been something that's been her Achilles heel. She's one of the leading scorers in Region 21, but can't stay on the court. Here's Megan Parrish. Edwards looking to drive. And they're going to call a push-off. On Mish with the pushing off with her left arm there on the drive. Going to be her first foul. If you're just joining us early on, it's 8:32 left here. In the first quarter, we're just getting underway from Bishop Conley. In the corner, that's a wide open three. No good. Rebounded by the boss, Deborah Banks.
Good long pass right there. Quickly stolen away.
Good thought, but a good defense by the... Oh, that's a carry. Referee didn't call it.
Nope, didn't see it.
Good ball movement. I don't know who she was throwing to. Throwing to another fan and player.
I don't even think she was throwing it to the fans.
I need like a... I need binoculars to see the numbers for North Country. It's really that bad.
Yeah. I can see that with Sydney Craig on Megan Parrish. Rosensteel.
From the free throw line and the foul. Shannon Rosensteel from the free throw line gets the foul. She'll go to the line to try to complete the three-point play. BCC comes into tonight's contest 6-9, 5-6 in Region 21. North Country 7-7 on the season. 0-1 in their conference. Shannon Rosensteel gets a three-point play. Shannon Rosensteel leads the team in scoring and rebounding with 15 points and 7 boards per game. Now BCC in a 2-3. Oh, there's a steal by Rosensteel. So versatile. Gets it getting into the passing lane. Doesn't have the numbers. Puts it. Misses. Gets her own rebound. Try to put it back up, but she's going to go to the free throw line for two.
Good job there drawing the foul, doing it all herself.
BCC is going to win this game. They need a big performance out of Shannon. Nice stroke there by Rosensteel. Nice stroke from the free throw line, making her first three free throws of the game. BCC playing some good D, and then they force a travel.
This is something we've seen the Bayhawks been able to do is make the other team force mistakes. And there's one right there, able to get the ball back on a travel. Long throw.
Here's Luna trying to get inside the Banks. Good defense there by, goodness gracious.
Someone on North Country.
Number 23 is Diamante Cancel. Ooh, driving baseline. Trying to dish it was Sydney Craig.
Calling steps again on him.
You predicted a big game from Sydney Craig. Sydney Craig is number 15.
I mean, it's not a bad name.
It sounds like a legit game, like a legit name, doesn't it? Like a legit WNBA name?
Sydney Craig. Yeah, I can see it.
Yeah. Here's Megan Parrish. North Country picking up full court.
Ooh, easy nice passes ball. Right here.
There you go. Good shot, good look. Luna gets her shot blocked. And being tripped up is...
I believe that it was Aaliyah McCray. Was that number 3, Aaliyah McCray?
I cannot see her number. Maybe she's just too small. I can't see her.
Travel would have been stolen anyway.
7-4. 7-4 BCC. BCC on a 7-0 run, Craig. They start, you know, North Country came out gangbusters with a 4-0 lead, and last couple minutes, Shannon Rosensteel's taking over, and BCC's played some good defense. They have a 7-4 lead early on.
Yeah, and after those
full
first...
Full court press.
After those first 4 points, North Country not playing very good, but they're playing very aggressive against Misa Edwards. I think they're saying she stepped out of bounds.
Yeah, they forced her to the sideline, forced her out of bounds. So North Country coming out with that press. They swing it around the perimeter, a three-point shot. Bounces up. North Country comes away with it. New shot clock.
Sidney Craig trying to direct traffic.
BCC with that 2-3 zone from the wing. No good.
That was
Bridget Rust.
She missed her second three in a row. This one goes out of bounds, so the Bayhawks are going to take it.
Yeah, Bridget Rust missed two three-pointers from the same spot.
All right. Long
oh,
throw,
nice
wide
pass
open.
To Katia Luna. Oh, too strong.
That was two bags. That was a perfect play right there.
Yeah, she rushed it.
They're going to call technical on Katia Luna.
Referee's a little sensitive. A little sensitive here today.
This is the second one he's called this game.
I'm not sure.
Well, she wasn't bad-mouthing anybody.
I didn't see.
She called that because she missed the layup. You know, she's just frustrated because she missed that shot.
Yeah, I don't see why they'd call a technical foul on that. But
no, it wasn't addressed towards anybody. Nonetheless.
Number 15, Sidney Craig, makes both technical foul shots. 7-6. North Country will keep the ball here. Bridget Russ to inbound for North Country. Amiria Tucker in the corner to Rust. Gets it back to Rust. I mean, back to Amiria Tucker. Miss. Ooh, dangerous pass. Almost stolen by Parrish. Ooh, almost steps right there.
I was thinking almost a double dribble, too. Got away with it.
Almost a lot of things. Swing it in the corner. Rust lost control of it. Puts it up at the shot clock buzzer. It's going to go out of bounds. And it'll be BCC basketball.
She had a good chance at a three, but just bobbled it.
Yeah, she would have had an open shot. North Country constantly putting pressure, full court, on the Bayhawks. Katia Luna, that's her shot. Way off. Rebounded by Rust. North Country, right through the teeth of the defense.
Nope, it's an ugly layup.
Not sure how BCC let her get all the way to the hoop.
Yeah. No, but her problem was once she got there, she didn't know what to do with it. She kind of just threw it up and hoped for the best.
Shannon Rhodes still will come in for Misha Edwards. The Saints inbound to the ball now. Trying to get inside to cancel, can't do it. In the corner for three, Bridget gets it to go. Bridget rushed for three, and North Country takes the lead 8-7, and they pick up full court press.
North Country playing an all-or-nothing defense right now.
Oh, goodness.
That was a great bounce
That's
pass.
That's too bad. BCC rushing. There's a three by Romeria Tucker. She drains it. Back-to-back threes by North Country, 12-7 now.
That was actually number 15, Sidney Craig. As I said, she's going to have a big game.
That's the way you break a press. That's the way you do it. Adia Contractor underneath, yes.
Great job breaking the defense.
Good passing. That's the way you break the press down.
Yeah, team that's playing so far up, you just got to throw it right over them.
Another three by Russ in the corner. She's not afraid to tee it up, that looks like.
Now North Country doing a lot of the same plays.
Luna thought about three. Gets it inside to the boss, Deborah Banks. Turn around.
She got stuffed, and they're calling up and down.
Well, they're going to call a jump. It's going to be possession arrow in favor of the North Country Community College Saints. And it's going to be Bayhawks basketball. They'll dump it into Rosesteel. Oh, she gets it blocked. Turn around by Banks.
I'm kind of surprised she shot that.
Who, Banks?
Yeah, it kind of looked like she was going to pass it back.
Yeah, she got caught in between, not knowing what she was going to do, whether she was going to pass it or shoot it. They swing it in the corner. Inside, cancel. Turns around, gets fouled. The foul's going to be on Shannon Rhodes-Steele. She's already got two, and she's coming out. She's coming out. Adia Contractor's going to go in.
Like we said, this is the problem we've seen in the last few games. Rosensteel's been in foul trouble a lot.
Gotta be disciplined when you're down there covering those low post players. Gotta keep your feet, keep your position. First shot made by Cancel. Diamante Cancel at the line. Drains the first free throw, 13-9. BCC hanging in there from the team from New York. Harris pushing it up to Mish Edwards. Parrish at the top to Banks. That's a deep three by Luna. No good. Banks gets it ripped away by Cancel. Cancel in the corner. Baseline jumper is good. With Banks in her face.
That was a nice pass.
You get a pass the ball against the press.
Yep.
Harris with a shot that was way off. Deep pass. Mish Edwards back there playing safety. Tips it out of bounds.
From the first look, I thought it was a buzzer beater with 2:52 left.
Oh, yeah.
I had no idea what she was trying to do.
Throwing a Hail Mary down there.
Yeah. Name of the Saints, play like the Packers, you know?
Yeah. Big games this weekend.
Oh, yeah.
All right, inbound it. Bayhawks in zone. 17 on the shot clock. And they're going to call a foul on Mish Edwards, it looks like. It is. It'll be a foul on Mish Edwards. And that's going to be 5 team fouls on the home team, so... That's going to put North Country in the bonus.
Yeah, I meant to bring this up a while ago. Was North Country had 4 fouls within the first 2 minutes with the Bayhawks getting none, but now the rules have been reversed with Bayhawks.
With 5 straight fouls.
5 straight fouls in a row.
First free throw missed. Ramiria Tucker. Misses both. Rebounded by Banks. Harris thought about 3, gets it to Luna.
Lisa Edwards wide open in the corner.
Oh, contractor. Ooh.
That was a very light pass and almost got taken away.
And just as you said that, Craig, earlier about North Country getting 4 fouls right at the start and not getting any more, there it is.
I like to make calls, you know?
You like to make calls.
Yep.
Edwards drains the first one. Coming out of the game is going to be number 3, Aaliyah McCray. Second free throw is no good. Ramiria Tucker. 15 on the shot clock. On the drive, who are they going to call a foul on? Another foul on Mish Edwards. BCC can't afford to get in foul trouble, Craig. They have only 6 players again on Tuesday. They lost one of their returning players who missed a lot of the season, DJ Eason. They lost her to a head injury, and now she's out. So now they're back down to 6 players. All right, so we have a timeout here on the court. 2:03 left to play here in the first quarter. And the North Country Saints, like I said, they're 7-7. They're 0-1 in conference play this season. This is the first time these two teams have ever met. Not sure how this just came about, but this is like the mystery game of the season, and we're doing it here on a Thursday night.
Thursday night in front of a packed audience.
Impact on
you know.
Yes. Phantom audience. And now the Bayhawks earned their 6th victory of the season on Tuesday. It was their most dominant performance of the season. They beat Bunker Hill by 70. Megan Parrish and Katia Luna led all scorers with 24 points apiece. Katia Luna had about 6 or 7 threes. She was unbelievable. And your girl there, DJ Banks, I mean, Deborah Banks had a career high of 23 rebounds. Adia Contract had 17. They were monstrous on the boards against a Bunker Hill team who was supremely overmatched. So BCC holding their own.
It's definitely what you like to see coming back from the vacation.
Yeah, most definitely.
You know, and people might be questioning, you know, maybe they're a little rusty, you know, how much did they practice during the vacation, but definitely showing they still came to play.
Yeah, well, BCC had a three-game win streak before the break, before they lost to Roxbury in their last game. Roxbury is the number one team in the country. They lost 105-49 their last game of the break. Then they came back a couple of weeks ago against CCRI and got blown out 61-45, but a good bounce back game against Bunker Hill, winning that game 100-30, as I said. So, but again, they're shorthanded. Only six players. You know, that could take its toll on you. We'll see how it goes going forward. First free throw made.
And they definitely got to start playing like they were last game. No, still a close game. We're not even done with the first quarter, but definitely want to start playing better.
That's for sure. Well, you remember, Craig, early in the season, BCC was out of it by the second quarter. You know, a lot of these games are at least hanging in there. Here comes a full court press. Here comes a trap. Misa Edwards gets by it. Parrish for three. Gets it. Megan for the trifecta.
They're only going to give her two on that
one.
Only
give her two. And she must have stepped on the line. They're a good passing team. North Country unselfish on the offensive end. Come up empty-handed, though. Here's Edwards. Swings at the Parrish. She'll tee it up from three again. No good. Banks is there. Can't get it. Banks doing a good job on the offensive boards, but can't connect on the putback. Pass to Romeric from Romeria Tucker to Cancel. Diamante Cancel with the jumper.
Almost rolled off her fingers, but she's able to recover, get it in for two.
Yeah.
Now we got less than a minute left in this quarter.
BCC getting in their offense from the top. No good by Edwards. Rebounded by Megan Parrish. Jumper is no good.
Well, no one's down the court.
Tucker to push it. Nice bounce pass inside. And the dish. There it is.
Great passing. That's probably the best thing we've seen from North Country is their passing game.
Yeah, good unselfishness. And on the score, that was... They're getting inside. Adia Contractor. Ooh. No continuation. Contractor at the line, 17.7 left to go here in the first quarter. And she banks it, she makes it. Tucker bringing it up. 1-2-2 defense by the Bayhawks. I think they're gonna call steps.
I don't know what they're calling something.
Yeah, they call steps on Yvette Santana. Two in the shot clock, gonna put it up. Why are you passing it? Throw that up. And that's gonna be the end of the first quarter, folks. 21-15. The North Country Community College Saints have the lead here at the end of the first quarter. So, Craig, I know you noticed there's been a coaching change here for the Bristol Community College Bayhawks. Coach Serge Moniz begins his coaching career. Starting last game. So Coach Serge Moniz is the new head coach for the Bristol Community College Bayhawks, taking over for Coach Aaron Morrell. Aaron Morrell has been a two-year coach here, and not sure exactly why the coaching change was made. Coach Aaron Morrell did a great job, brought a lot of these girls in from Florida and the Midwest, different places, recruiting around the area, did a good job. But nonetheless, Serge Moniz is here, and he's the head man now for Bristol Community College.
When you talk about recruiting from all around, Misa Edwards from the Virgin Islands, and she was actually a member of the Virgin Islands national soccer team.
Yeah.
So a very versatile athlete, is she?
Yep, Shannon Rhodes deal from Sunrise, Florida. And the roster is now shortened, but there were some other girls from other parts of the country as well. So, we wish Coach Amorell luck in all his endeavors going forward. Jumper from the free throw line. It's good.
Great job breaking the defense, bouncing it everywhere all around. It's getting it through everybody.
That was Romeria Tucker with the jumper. Parrish cross court. Knocked away by Tucker. I beg to differ with you. I think Romeria Tucker, I think she's the engine that makes this North Country train go. David Cardozer and the Portuguese Cowboy on the call here from Bishop Conley. BCC has to find that energy. They need to find the energy they were playing with. Katia Luna gets it knocked away.
They're going to call a foul on her, or not on Luna, but Luna's going to go to the line. And North Country playing very aggressive defense.
Yes, they are. It's that long ride from NY.
Yeah, but it's working for them. We've seen BCC, they try those long passes, and North Country not afraid just to get in front of it and block it.
No, definitely not.
So coming in, that is Aaliyah McCray coming in for, I believe that was 23, Diamante cancel.
Yes.
Luna sinks that one. 23-17, 9-18 left.
In a corner, that's Russ. She likes to shoot from the outside. Ooh, that one knocked away.
That was lucky.
BCC
was
comes
unlucky.
Away with a loose basketball. Here comes Megan Parrish. Megan, oh, loses control if it goes out of bounds. But they're going to call a foul.
The foul's going to be on Megan Parrish, I believe.
No. No, no, no. Foul's going to be on number three.
Oh, nope. Looked like they were raising up a 3-0.
Liam McCray. Parrish falls to the floor, can't connect. Up ahead to Rust, puts it up off the glass, no good. Rebounded, throwing it high in the air. Wow.
That one just went straight up, and she's really lucky it fell.
Yes. That's Kadricia Theok, now being doubled. Oh, loose ball.
Forcing Edwards to make a bad pass. Easy layup.
Easy layup. Easy for you to say. Sherika Williamson.
Now the men's team appear to be filing in. Or going to get ready for their practice after this game.
Yeah, hopefully get this place riled up a little bit.
It's always fun when the men's team is here, so.
Yeah. Russ into Romeria. Back to Russ in the corner. Nice play, but couldn't get it to fall. Shannon Roden's deal. Ooh, lost control of it. Puts it up. No good. Little hesitant, Shannon. Out in the open floor. I thought she was a little hesitant settling for that jumper there.
And she came in with a head full of steam, but eventually just ran out.
Yeah, she ran out of gas.
Didn't really know what to do with it.
How is this shot always open for three? Russ can't get it. Rebounded by Rodensteel.
And we got a LeBron James on the court.
We got a LeBron James. Did he do some kind of a flop or something tonight? I still haven't seen it.
Yeah, he flopped. I didn't see it either, but I keep hearing about it. Yeah, he flopped hard.
Yeah, I heard it was nuts. Haven't actually seen it.
Well, they just got blown out by the Warriors. And then the Warriors just destroyed the Thunder.
Gotta love it. Basketball season heating up now with football almost over. This is the bridge to get us to the spring. Parrish over to Luna. That's her spot on the wing. No good. Ooh, nice effort there by North Country. That was Diamante Cancel.
Seen a lot of inconsistency from the three-point line this game, from both sides, actually.
Rose still goes baseline. I believe she had it blocked. She had it blocked by Cardisha Theok.
One thing you got to love about Shannon Rosenstiel, though, is she'll go right back for it. She saw she was getting blocked, saw no one was going for it, got it right back herself.
That's true, and I think she needs to be more aggressive. I think she's a little hesitant to be more aggressive because she does get in foul trouble, so she's like, you know, maybe sometimes kind of shies away from mixing it up. Inbound pass knocked away by number 15.
It's Sydney Craig.
Miss Sydney Craig. In the corner. Banks gets it to drop.
It's a great quick release. Second she got it, put it up.
Yeah, kind of laid on the back of the rim there and just fell in. Oh, they get inside. Nice thought. Nice entry pass by Bridger Russ, but
Russ loves that corner.
Yeah, she does. She stays in that corner.
Oh.
Ooh, Megan nice Parrish. Hustle there. Oh, what a hustle there by Leah McRae. Now she's on the floor like Rondo over here.
Megan Parrish got kind of thrown off. That one came up and hit her in the face.
Yeah. Weird sequence. Misha Edwards will come in for Adia Contractor, number 33. Number 15, Misha Edwards in the game now. BCC, to me, has three good guards that all have the ability to shoot and score, and you add that with Shannon Rosenstiel in the interior and Deborah Banks doing the dirty work on the drive. That foul is going to be on number 22, Sherika Williamson. Banks misses the first one. Close game, 25-19. A lot of basketball left to be played here in the river. And Banks wills that one in, 25-20. 14 fouls. Ooh, getting into. That pass knocked away by Misha Edwards. Good defensive effort there.
That's definitely the right idea, just didn't come up with it.
New shot clock for North Country. I mean, full shot clock. Sydney Craig gets it down inside to Erin DeVries, loses it. Rose is still on the open floor. Coast to coast, off the glass, and in. Lays it up and in.
No
the
hesitation.
Woman of steel.
No hesitation on that. She knew exactly what she was doing.
Oh, that ball picked off by Parrish.
This is exactly what BCC needed.
Parrish in the open floor. Gets it inside to Banks. Nice pass. And Deborah Banks will go to the free throw line. Yep.
Something we've seen from Deborah Banks over the weeks, she's been very good with foul shots.
That's for sure. And Megan Parrish, great job. Always finding the open, always finding an open teammate. One thing about Megan Parrish, though, I find that she falls in love with her right hand driving to her right. You know, and then a lot of times she's getting cut off there. She needs to take the ball the other way. Needs to develop that left hand, cross, get a little crossover. She'll be golden.
Yeah, putting up Isaiah Thomas numbers.
Yeah, something like that.
Sure, he's actually a lefty, but that doesn't count.
25-23, five team fouls for North Country, no team fouls for BCC.
We talked about it last quarter. They've just kind of been switching off from fouls.
Yeah. Sydney Craig. They'll dump it in. Try to dump it in to Kredisha Theok. Diamante canceled, throwing that ball out of bounds. North Country relentless with this press. BCC not doing a bad job. Luna, oh, she had an open drive.
She had all the time in the world. That's a big mistake. Chance.
Yes. Russ for three, bangs it. Bridget Russ for three, 28-23 the score.
Russ showing she doesn't have to just be in that left corner the whole game. She can shoot from the right corner.
Luna. Deborah Banks. Comes up short.
Who knows? No one went after that shot. No one went up for a rebound.
Finally collapsed on that. Turnaround is canceled. Back out. Jumper. Off the glass and in. That's number 22, Sherika Williamson. She's a guard, a freshman guard, 5'4" from North Miami. Parrish, driving to her left, has daylight, puts it up and in.
Making it look easy on that one.
Well, this time she does drive to her left. Bridget Russ for three. No good. North Country trying to call a timeout. Not getting it. The girl's not giving it to him. Deep three by Sydney Craig. No good.
Honestly, North Country was lucky they had the ball for as long as they did.
Edwards. Rhodes steal. Makes a move. And she's going to get fouled. And she'll go to the line. Good job by Shannon Rhodes still to stay in this game and stay out of foul trouble, be on the court for her team. Foul's going to be on number 23, Diamante Cancel. That's her third.
Yeah, you can see her arguing after the call. She thought she got all ball on that one.
I didn't see a technical there. Number 14, Katimia Smith.
Nope, she's coming out of the game regardless.
And Shannon Rodensteel bangs home both free throws, 30-27. 4:23 left in the first half. Oh, nice steal by Megan.
Showing the ups on that steal.
Yeah. Edwards kicks it back out to Megan Parrish, swings it over to Luna for three. No good. Rebounded by Kredisha Theok.
Sydney Craig trying to direct traffic.
She does a good job of it. Good ball movement. Knocked it. Stolen. BCC coming away with a lot of steals.
If there's one direction you don't want to throw it in, it's Megan Parrish's direction.
Yeah, she's getting a lot of steals. Edwards behind her back.
It was a nice no look, but not to the right person.
Going back the other way. North Country. That's Sydney Craig. Misses the layup. And then there's going to be a foul. And they're going to call a foul on North Country. Foul's going to be a number 31, Kredisha Theok.
It looks like Parrish is going to go to the line. I believe this is North Country's probably their sixth straight foul.
And BCC has zero here in the second quarter. Playing good defense, getting in the pass lane, causing turnovers. Doing a good job of handling the press by North Country. The North Country press seemed to give BCC fits at the beginning of the game, but it really hasn't been a factor thus far here in the second quarter.
Megan Parrish about to take her second shot from the line, where she's shooting 65% of her shots she makes. Leads the team in foul shots.
Yeah, she's always at the line.
Shooting percentage, at least.
BCC in the zone. Another turnover. And here comes the Bayhawks. Got the numbers. Edwards leading the charge. Nice dish to Rodesteel.
They're calling a foul on Misa Edwards.
Oh, they call a foul on Misa Edwards. That was a nice dish there. That's too bad.
The ref's being tough this game.
Wow.
You know, obviously, we don't have the best perspective, but just looked like a great pass and a great layup.
No, Craig, we have the best perspective.
We do have the best perspective.
2-3 zone. 30-28. That was the first team foul, too, by BCC. Stolen by Rodesteel. Take it to the bank. Rodesteel. Yeah. Oh, misses her first shot. Can't connect on her second shot. Banks is there. Can't get it. Three attempts at it. Can't get it.
It's going to stay down here, though, so
Man. They
might get another chance. But, yeah, like you said, just not good there. A wide-open layup, then a missed shot, and then two other missed shots after that.
Yeah, Shannon's got to – it seems she comes to a complete stop on these layups. She needs to really follow through with those layups.
Like we said, she's probably just scared of getting fouled again, going into foul trouble.
Ugh. It's too bad. But BCC hanging in there, 30-28. We get a good game here in the first half. If you're just joining us, North Country Community College is a college from New York. They made the trip up here today. And this is the first time these two teams have played, so it looks like it's going to be a barn burner. Bayhawks averages 63 points per game on the season. They've had a couple times where they've scored over the 100-point mark. This one's a low-scoring affair. Parrish swings it over to Misha Edwards. Edwards keeps her pivot foot. In the lane, Shannon Rodesteel, nice touch, puts it up and in. Gets the bounce. 30-30. I said if BCC had a chance today, Shannon Rodesteel had to step up, and she has.
This is the first time that the Bayhawks have tied this game since they were both at 7 back in the first.
It's amazing, and they finally caught up now.
Now the Bayhawks get their second foul.
Sherika Williamson in the basket in the corner, being guarded by Megan Parrish. Craig setting up the play for North Country. BCC doing a great job of getting steals. Driving the lane to Santana, no good. Rebounded by Idiot Contractor.
I think my eyes have finally adjusted to the North Country numbers.
Just a tad. Rodesteel driving to her left, loses the basketball. And who comes away with it? None other than Sydney Craig. Craig takes it middle. Stops for the jumper at the elbow, no good. Bayhawks always looking to push. Edwards for three. Bounces up. No good. Rebounded by Erin DeVries. Oh, teeing it up. Craig misses.
No good.
Oh, BCC got the numbers. A 3-on-2 break. In the corner, Parrish. Jumper's good. Megan.
We got 52 seconds left in this quarter.
BCC takes their first lead since it was 7-4. Jumper missed by Craig. Misa Edwards to Parrish. Oh, nice move.
Ooh.
Oh, but she can't get it to fall. Nice move to avoid the defender and get a layup attempt, but she misses. 20 on the shot clock, 25 on the game clock.
Oh,
was a nice pass. Mishandled by Craig. Ooh, they're getting inside. Parrish back out to DeVries, off the glass. too hard. Bayhawks will come away with it. Holding for the last shot.
So Edwards lost that one.
Megan needs to she needs to heave it. Put it up for three. Parrish for three. But gets it to go. Megan.
Who else but Megan Parrish to hit a three at the buzzer?
Wow. Looked like that was going nowhere, and Megan Parrish drains a three-pointer at the half to put BCC up 35-30 at the half. That's my favorite player, Megan Parrish. So at the half, 35-30, the Bayhawks have the lead as David Cardoza and Craig Salvador on the call. It's Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media. Stay tuned for the second half. All right, so BCC has the lead. BCC trailed for most of the first half after going up 7-4. Went on a late run. Megan Parrish had a three-pointer at the half to give BCC a 35-30 lead.
And speaking of three-pointers, Luna missed that one, got tipped away from her, and it fell short.
Sherika Williamson in the lane, drives the lane and misses. Shannon Rodensteel, Megan Parrish, the top scorers in the first half for BCC. Bristol in their home white uniforms with the green trim. And in the dark uniforms, North Country. Deborah Banks in the corner, no good. Rips it away, nice effort there by Banks. Can't get it to go, rebounded by Kardrika Theok.
I was gonna say the dark, impossible to read black uniforms that North Country wears.
Yeah, it's like camouflage, you cannot see it. BCC, very active hands on defense, very active in the passing lanes, doing a great job of forcing turnovers.
I think they're catching on to the fact that North Country really has just about three plays that they've been running this whole game.
Yeah.
Shot clock winds down.
Shot clock winded down. BCC with a good defensive stop. Here comes Edwards. Parrish. Ooh.
Oh.
I don't think Deborah was expecting that. On the other end, laying it up and in. It's Sydney Craig.
Deborah Banks just in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Yeah, she was not expecting that pass.
I think it was just a pass to Edwards, and I think that Deborah Banks just got in the way.
Shannon, like, she likes getting the ball right there. Parrish, cross-court pass. Acadia Luna somehow ends up in her hands. Misses a three.
Yeah.
Megan always looking for Acadia Luna cross-court. That time, Katia couldn't connect. And that jumper is going to be by...
I can't hear anymore, though.
Number 23, Diamante Cancel.
Okay.
They like putting Shannon at the top. Jumper by Luna. Good. Katia Luna with the jumper from the elbow.
That's her shot. We've said this before.
I hear a buzzing in my ear. To 34. BCC on top. Shannon Rose still come out for a break.
Well, Dave, I think that buzzing you are hearing is the ghost of the BCC Bees, what we used to be called before we became the Bayhawks.
Awful, what an awful name.
Yeah, I know. I didn't like it either.
Travel called on Misha Edwards.
Should have been the Hornets. That would have been cool. Instead of the Bees.
The Hornets.
Yeah. Now think about it. It still would have been cool. It's a cool logo idea.
It doesn't go, though. Bristol Community College Hornets.
No, it doesn't go, but better than Bees.
Bristol has to have a B. It has to be a B name.
Yeah. That isn't Bees.
Yeah. Not Bees. Bringing the ball up the court for North Country is Miss Sydney Craig. BCC in his own defense. Oh, nice pass. Oh, the miss. Missed by.
That didn't even look like a pass. It just looked like a shot that she got hit with and just kind of threw it down.
Yeah, missed by Cancel. Fake it. Nice fake. Edwards gets a short jumper. No good. Rebounding going the other way. Driving all the way to the hole. Misses it. Romeria Tucker with the miss. Megan always looking to push, always looking to create. Short jumper is no good, way off, air ball.
She did a good job getting down the line and then pump faking to fake out the blocker.
Yeah, that was a good pump fake.
Fake out the defender. Just couldn't fall with the jumper.
Turn around jumper, turns around and it's good. Number 23, Diamante, cancel.
We have ourselves a one-point game with 6:10 remaining in the third.
Edwards for three. No good.
So let me see with Edwards when she's taking that three-pointer. She always takes that extra second, maybe to set herself, but that extra second could be costly at times.
Yeah, she's allowing the defender to get up on her. And it's just a little bit of hesitation.
That has been kind of the Bayhawks' problem this game, is hesitation. We've seen it from her, we've seen it from Rosensteel, Katya Luna at times at the three-point line.
But BCC's been all over the place on defense. So getting inside, loose ball, coming away with his Mish Edwards. Edwards brings it middle, then takes it to the side to Parrish. Knocks it down. Megan likes that short jumper in the corner. Driving to the middle, all the way to the rack, and lays it in. Romeria Tucker, 5'9" guard from Universal Avonread. I guess that's the high school.
Hey, credit where credit was due. It was very impressive getting around the Bayhawks defense.
That's for sure. And they're going to call a foul there. That's going to be on Bridget Rust. As Mish Edwards was going around her, wrapping her arm was Bridget. Her second foul.
That was risky.
Ooh, Parrish getting knocked to the floor. That's going to be a foul. Get back up. Can't afford to lose you.
Nope. Now Bayhawks can't afford to get injured. They've had a slew of injuries this season. See Misa Edwards, her ankle been bothering her the last couple games we saw. And then, like you said, one of the returning players out with a head injury.
Yeah. Taking it to the rack is Misa Edwards. She gets knocked down, as you were just talking about her having some knee problems or leg problems.
She appears to be fine, though.
Yes, Deja Eason, as I was talking about, the ties to the Midwest that Coach Morrell had. She's from Chicago, Illinois. She's a guard that's been out a lot of the season with different kinds of injuries. She got hurt on Tuesday night. It was a scary injury. She was down on the floor for a long time, and the ambulance actually came and took her off on a stretcher. Apparently, it was a head injury. I think she may, don't want to speculate, but it was definitely something in the upper neck head region, possible concussion. So
yeah, if she's knocked out even for a second, that's a grade 3 concussion.
Yeah,
minimum of a month on the shelf.
Not good.
No.
Deep three, way off. Adia Contractor now with the rebound. Romeria Tucker with the miss.
Adia Contractor with a look what I found kind of play.
Yeah. Driver to her left now. I think Megan heard me. Ever since I said that she likes to drive to her right too much times, she's driven to her left a few times. After I said that, that was a good take. Oh, Megan underneath. Nice pass. Good look. By Katya Luna, good inbound play. And BCC is up 5, 43-38. Driving. Oh, nice pass by Craig. Takes it to the middle and drops it off to Diamante. Cancel. They score the basket?
I believe so. I believe it's timeout called.
Timeout is called. All right, timeout is called 43-40. Here's the score, 4:18 left to play. We'll be right back. feel like we got a little Spygate going on. Yeah. Like, Craig, run over there and tell them. I'll relay what they're saying over there.
Oh, yeah.
Relay their game plan. Relay the strategy.
A little bit of Spygate going on.
Spygate. That's it. All right, we're back here on FR Media, Channel 95, and your Comcast dial. Hope you're watching. You can find these games on YouTube, too. The Bristol Community College Bayhawks have our own YouTube station. Go on there and put in the search engine. There's a three-pointer by Luder. It's good. The trifecta. That's a deep three by Romaria Tucker.
Wow.
And she matches Luna's three. 46-43.
In North Country, not to be outdone. Want to try to one-up the Bayhawks every chance they get.
Yeah. Just go on YouTube and put in Bristol Community College Bayhawks basketball. You can find all these games. Yeah. Myself, yours truly, and oh, that ball sails out of bounds. Not time for BCC to get sloppy.
Almost took out the statistician.
The statistician.
Hey, he gets hit in the face and he calls the turnover.
We'll drop it inside. Now back out for three. Romaria Tucker banks it home.
Ooh, and just like that, this game is now tied.
And pumps her fist, yes. Back-to-back threes by Romaria Tucker. It's 46-46. Inside of Shannon Rodensteel. Shannon time, no good.
Up, Shannon time, maybe next time.
Driving is Luna, not her forte. Gets it knocked away.
Nope, tough Rust. To go over everyone when they're taller than you.
And they'll call a travel there.
It's too bad because she made that shot.
Yeah.
It's always when it doesn't count is when you do it.
That's for sure.
Yeah. It's like passing the practice test and failing your final.
That always stinks.
Yeah.
Megan modestly walking it up. Edwards to a cutting Rodensteel, putting up out the window. No good, a little too hard. Good setup, good play, but nothing doing. Here's Romaria Tucker, starting to come alive. Oh, that's a travel. Oh,
yeah. Big time.
Yes. And again, Craig, five team fouls for the guests, North Country Saints.
Still zero from the Bayhawks.
Yeah. That bounce pass goes off the foot of the Saints. I don't know what you attribute that to, the fact that they got no fouls. Is that good discipline, or is it just, I don't know.
I'm still just thinking about how that ball went out of bounds, kick off the foot. Kind of funny.
Yeah. Soccer style. I was going to say, the fact that they have no fouls, practically no fouls the last couple quarters, is that good defense, good discipline, or is it just like vanilla defense? I don't think it's vanilla defense. They've been all over the place. Getting a lot of steals, a lot of turnovers.
Might just be getting the benefits of the call. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
But it's another foul, so Edwards going to the line.
And it'll be two, and she'll drain it. 47-46. BCC shooting much better from the line today.
They're definitely shooting better from the line. They have been a little bit inconsistent from the field this game. But especially with layups.
Yeah.
But no, the three-point shooting's been pretty good, and their foul shooting's been very well this game.
A lot of improvements. Ooh, cross court. I don't know how she found Bridget for three. Up is Rodensteel. And they're going to call a foul.
I believe that one's going to be
on cancel. Not sure who they called that foul on. Or maybe it was Sherika Williamson. With the basketball is Parrish. Edwards driving to her left, loses the basketball.
It.
Now
trying
it's on the
back.
Floor.
It's kind of dribbled off herself, lost control of it.
Yeah, it's too bad. But then those two The possession arrow goes in the favor of North Country on the loose ball. BCC doing a good job shifting with that defense. Driver to a left. Tucker with the floater, no good. Gets her own rebound. Puts up another floater, and that time makes it. Romerier Tucker, 48-48. Minute 17 to play, third quarter. Craig, what do you think about Romerier Tucker? She's really come alive. She was part of the starting lineup. She was kind of quiet in the first half, but the second half, a couple three-pointers, a couple layups. She's really inserted herself in this game now.
Yeah, well, like I always say, it's not about how you start, it's about how you finish. And if you can show a better second half than you do a first half, then that'll definitely take the game a long way. She had a good job last play. You know, she knew she missed her shot, went right for it, got her own rebound, put up that easy two, you know.
Yeah, she's definitely been a big vital cog for them. Luna, oh, nice fake. Takes it in, puts it about the glass. Nice take by Katia Luna.
It's good to see her do that, too. We always see her as a three-point shooter. It's a good job driving it down for a layup.
Yes. Last game in this game, she's done a better job of not being so quick to pull the trigger, but using that up fake to her advantage, bringing it in for a better, more high-percentage shot. Deep three. Sydney Craig off the side of the rim. Luna with the rebound now. Shot clock is off. We're down to the final 15 seconds here in the first half. Luna thought about three again. This time driving to her left. Puts it up way too hard.
North Country hustling.
It's going to be Craig. Bridget Russ for three. No good. Parrish rebounds it. And that's the end of the third quarter. So at the end of three, it's been a tightly contested contest here at Bishop Connolly High School, the home of the Bayhawks, as they lead 50-48 as we come to the final quarter. Between these two teams, North Country making the long drive here today in a game that really just came up on the schedule on a whim. Kind of been in the fold the last couple weeks. And they've made the trip up here, and they're looking to knock off BCC on their home court. But BCC's had a good showing, facing a team they never faced before. You know, a team from New York. You know, sometimes, you know, could be a little intimidation factor, and this is BCC's, this is their first season of being back after a two-year hiatus, and they've won six ball games. They held their own. They're 5-6 in the region, 6-9 overall. But they're looking for their seventh victory today, second in a row. Looking to make it three in a row if they could win this game on Saturday. So this could be a big win and a big confidence booster for BCC if they can knock out this North Country team. Kind of the unknown when you're facing a team that, you know, from that you that's not in your conference, that you never faced before, that just kind of came up. You don't know what to expect, but they're hanging right with these girls.
Yeah, not in your conference, not even your region. We've seen some Rhode Island teams, so that's about the only other team out of state we play.
Yeah.
So interesting seeing a New York team come in.
Ooh, ball knocked away. BCC doing a good job on defense. Here's Megan Parrish. Gets it inside. Banks, nice turnaround hook. Nice, that's it. That's the way to do it. Banks gets a position down way close to the basket. Turning around with a nice soft touch on the righty hook. Romeria Tucker for three. She's been hot, but she misses that one.
And Megan Parrish looked to get the rebound on that one, nicked off her, but she got lucky. It nicked off a Russ, too. So Bayhawks will come up with it.
Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
Yep.
Edwards goes to everybody and lays it in. Layup drill. Meesh.
It's good, clean offense right there.
Oh, I don't know what that was. She like passed it to herself. Oh, nice.
North Country getting really aggressive.
Yeah, well, how about that rebound by Banks? Pass by Parrish. Rodensteel. No good. Banks fighting for it.
Can't come down with it.
Going back the other way. Sydney Craig back out. Ramiria Tucker pulls the trigger. No good. Still with it. Sherika Williamson, no good. Too many second chance opportunities. And finally laying it in was Diamante. Cancel. 54-50.
Yeah, by the time the other team gets their eighth chance to shoot the ball, you really got to do something about that.
Got to put a body on somebody. Megan Parrish driving to her left. I swear she heard me. And she keeps crossing over to her left now. Lost that ball out of bounds. Sherika Williamson going out. Number coming in is number three. It's Aaliyah McCray. Edwards being guarded by McCray. Edwards back out to Rosensteel. Only five on the shot clock. Got to pull the trigger. Who else to do it? Parrish. Off. Off the mark. Wide left.
Yeah, uncharacteristic air ball by Megan Parrish.
Well, she had to shoot it up quickly. She got one before the half quickly. That one she had wide open, but it was way off. Nice job by Megan Parrish to knock it away. And the Bayhawks are going to take a timeout here. With 7:40 left to play, the game is in favor of the Bayhawks right now. And we're talking about Coach Serge Moniz taking over for Coach Aaron Morrell. He is the head coach now. Coach Moniz also teaches at New Bedford Vocational High School. I also believe that he's coached there for their junior varsity or varsity team. So Serge Moniz is the coach now.
I think I can tell what he's saying over there. He's telling Megan Parrish, you know, Megan, Dave Cardoza is telling you go for your left. So
go to your right. Yeah.
Don't listen to anything he's saying. He doesn't know anything.
Exactly. There's a reason why you're driving to your right. No, sir.
Got more of the men's team in the house now. Saw some of them before the half. A lot of others coming out.
Yeah, good to see those stands getting full. BCC men's team always supporting the ladies.
Yep. They're not just here because they have a practice after this. They want to see the game.
Yeah, that's what it is. They're going to call a foul. The foul is going to be on Shannon Rosensteel. Man, that's going to be her fourth.
This is the first foul we've seen by any Bayhawks player in the longest time.
Yeah, but Shannon Rosensteel picked up a couple early. Oh, nice. Nice inbound pass, and they get it to Sydney Craig. Sydney Craig lays it in. North Country down by two. I like what Serge Moniz is doing. He's constantly taking out Shannon to try to preserve her with her foul troubles. He's doing a good job of getting her in and out of there. Cross-court pass. Luna, quick drill. Oh, yes. Quick release. Beautiful on the cross-court pass from Parrish. Excellently executed.
And Luna been
Brett the Hitman Hart.
Luna been on with those three-pointers this game.
Yes. Three-pointer from the side. It's good.
Brett the Hitman Harp, definitely a sharpshooter.
Yes, definitely a Speaking of sharpshooter, right there, Sydney Craig returns a favor. That was a big three. Put the pressure on the Bayhawks now. Pick set by Banks. Going into the teeth of the defense. Nice lay-down pass by Megan Parrish. Excellently executed. The excellence of execution.
How many more wrestling references can we put in?
Oh, a million. Okay. Oh, losing the ball. Oh. Losing the ball is Tucker. Parrish comes away with it. Down pass to Edwards. Lost it, but it's going to be knocked away by, I believe, Bridget Rust. That was a nice pass by Parrish, though, to get it to Adia Contractor. Good job by her to knock it down. Banks! Deborah Banks is going to be able to score a lot of points once she knocks down a lot of these easy opportunities down low.
She's getting a million rebounds, so she's not doing anything with them.
Yeah, she just not consistent. You know, she gets a lot of offensive rebounds.
And now she just fouled.
Ooh, in the lane, getting fouled. And they're going to call that foul on Megan Parrish.
Just like that, three quick fouls in a row by the Bayhawks.
One thing about Megan, she never gets into really any serious foul trouble. That's only her second deep into the game now.
Everyone except Shannon Rosenthal, really. Everyone except Shannon Rosenthal, really. They've been playing very conservative, clean defense.
Yeah, BCC might have like seven fouls all day. Like four of them are like on Shannon. Critical moments around the 4 or 5 minute mark. I think Coach Serge Moniz needs to get her back in the game.
Exactly, it's only a 2-point game.
North Country coming back with that. Well, thought it was going to be full court pressure. Megan going to her left, puts it up with her left. Oh, shut me up. 61-57, nice drive to her left. Laying it up with the left is Megan Parrish. Ooh.
They're calling that on Parrish.
Just as I said that she doesn't foul that much. She knew she shouldn't have reached in on that one. And now we have four team fouls. Like you say, these fouls go in spurts. Four team fouls on the home team Bayhawks, zero on North Country.
I haven't been able to look yet, but I don't know how many people on North Country are in foul trouble.
Not too many. I mean, all the key players are in there, all the key suspects.
And Deborah Banks gets another foul. So now North Country, they're going to go on the bonus.
If you're North Country, you're going to keep taking it at them. I mean, the BCC's got players in foul trouble. They got five team fouls. You're going to be shooting two from here on out.
I mean, right now, North Country, they keep getting the benefit of the call, so you might as well just keep taking advantage of that if the refs are going to give it to you.
Right. They're going to make their free throws, though, Craig. Another miss. They've been awful from the free throw line today.
That is crucial right there. You can't miss. When they're giving you points like that.
Oh, trap.
Deborah Banks is not having a good quarter. No, when the refs are just going to give you points, you got to take them.
Got to take advantage of it. That's for sure. Inbounds of the basketball is going to be Diamante Cancel. Theok, try to get it into Cancel. Stolen away by Katia Luna. Oh, Misha Edwards.
Too much.
Oh, she should have ate that one. BCC with a chance to extend that lead a little bit more.
Nope.
And they keep turning the ball over here. North Country turns the ball over. BCC gives it right back.
Yeah, just careless mistakes.
They'll drop it in. Nice pass in the corner to Romaria Tucker. Air ball. Rebounded by Theok. Inside. No good. Santana, how are you going to let her go? How are you going to let her go in there and score? Santana is 5 feet tall. She gets in the rebound. You got to be kidding me.
It's not playing defense. You can't let that happen. It's one thing to let them get a second chance, but for something like that to happen?
I mean, Yvette Santana, sophomore, 5 feet, gets in there and scores the 2 points. But I mean, I don't know how they let her get in there rebound. I mean, she's so small she could hang glide on a Dorito.
Shannon Rose is still be coming back in the game for Adia Contractor. Miss Edwards about to take her second shot. North Country had their first foul of the quarter.
And this has to be Shannon time now.
5 minutes left, a close game. You know, she's got to be careful not to get fouled. Or Shannon time will quickly come to an end.
Yeah. Romaria Tucker, driving to her right, going up strong. Taking it strong.
It's going to be another foul. It's Deborah Banks again.
And we talked about BCC being disciplined on defense and, you know, causing a lot of turnovers, causing a lot of havoc, and not creating a lot of fouls. And the last couple minutes, they've kind of unraveled when it comes to that point.
Deborah Banks has gotten all four of her fouls this quarter.
They can't afford to lose her.
Can't afford to lose anybody.
Her and Shannon. They're two interior players. Parrish up to Mish Edwards. Edwards on the drive. Puts it up. No good. Fiok was a presence down there. Romeria Tucker driving. Kicks it back out. Yvette Santana tees it up for three. Bounces up. It drops in. Man.
Tough break for the Bayhawks. Everyone in disbelief that that one fell.
She got the Bristol bounce in Bristol, and they're North Country, 62-62. And, man, we got ourselves a ball game with 4:22 left here in the fourth quarter here at Bishop Connolly High School in Fall River, Massachusetts, home of the Bayhawks. It's Cardoza and Salvador on the call for FR Media.
Yeah, Bayhawks have just about tied their average as they're averaging 63 points a game on the season.
Yeah, the Bayhawks can put up points when they have to. Right now, the last couple minutes, I mean, they've really let North Country hang around, Craig. I mean, They had a decent lead. They were in control of the game. And they've kind of let North Country hang around because North Country isn't doing themselves any favors. They're turning the ball over, and the Bayhawks are getting the basketball, and they're making stupid mistakes, and they're throwing the ball away, and they're giving the ball right back to North Country. And North Country, you know, you can only keep making so many mistakes before it comes back to bite you in the butt, and that's what's happening right now. BCC has Shannon Rodensteel and Deborah Banks both in foul trouble. A scary situation here, Craig. Both those girls foul out, you're going to be down to four. And that's not going to bode well.
And we brought this up last quarter. Was Bayhawks were playing very clean, conservative defense, and North Country was, they were racking up the fouls, and now they've just appeared to switch.
Edwards for three. Oh.
It's not even that North Country's playing good defense. BCC's making a lot of careless errors.
They sure are. Oh, that's a nice pass. Nice pass by Romeria Tucker, finds Theok, Kardrika Theok down low with the red hair. They'll get inside of Banks. I think this is a good timeout here by Serge Moniz. I think this is a really good timeout. Your team had the lead. Your team's kind of been controlling the second half, and now they've lost it here in the last couple of minutes, seemingly coming undone. And now North Country takes the lead. You got to kind of reel back in the troops because you don't want them to lose total control of this game because, you know, the pressure's on now.
Yeah,
I think that's a good timeout to kind of calm them down and reset, reload. There's a lot of time left here, so, you know, it's a good chance to tell the troops, hey, no, don't panic, you know.
Yeah, exactly, especially with the big problem been endurance for this team because – they don't have a bench, you know.
Only six players right now.
Yeah, and they had seven, then one of them got hurt. And now two in foul trouble. It's not her fault, I know, but I'm just saying, you know, now two players in foul trouble.
You made it sound like it was her fault.
It's not her fault.
We had seven, but one of them got hurt.
Okay, it's not her fault.
You know, one of them had to get a concussion.
I've had concussions before. I know they're not fun, you know.
I had one serious concussion one time where I just couldn't. I felt like I was in a fog. There's something, you know.
Yeah, that's usually what happens. The way I describe it, when someone's talking to you, it's like they're speaking another language. Like you can hear what they're saying, but you have no idea what they're saying.
Yeah, you just want to lay down.
But we want to wish her the best of luck and hope she can be back soon.
Bayhawks lose the basketball. Coming up all the way, Craig, they just give her that layup. Vanilla defense there, and now this one's in jeopardy. Bayhawks need a good possession here. Nice hesitation there. Somehow Parrish. Luna in the corner. The jumper. It's good. God, that was big.
I think that one's only going to count for two.
Yeah, she was inside the line, or her toe was on the line. 66-64.
Still, though, she's been a very good shooter this game.
Shot Shot clock winded down. Someone's going to stop ball. Someone's going
to
get on that. Tucker loses it.
Rosenstiel down.
Another foul by Megan Parrish. And she's picked up a few. She's picked up a few fouls really quick.
Rosenstiel appears to be limping on that left ankle.
Hate to see that. Gonna need a mash unit for this team. And Romeria Tucker buries that. Rattles around, falls through, 67-64. Just under 3 minutes to play. The miss by Tucker, rebounded by Theok. They're gonna call a jump.
Yeah, Banks had a hand on it, but they're gonna call a jump and stay for North Country.
Yeah, they said black ball is going to be the Saints basketball, Craig. You're exactly right. Need a big defensive stop if you're the Bayhawks. Romeria Tucker, she's been doing a lot of handling of the basketball. She's been very assertive in the second half. There's a pick there at the top of the key. A on the shot clock. They'll get in the corner. Yvette Santana way off. Rebounded by Rosenstiel. BCC needs to slow the game down now. Parrish thought about it. Cross court for Luna. Luna to tie it. No.
That would have been clutch if somebody's been making a lot of shots this game.
Man, I give it to Katia. She is not scared.
That's a good asset to have.
She had the open shot. Losing it out of bounds is going to be Santana. 67-64. BCC needs a good, solid possession. Key possession here for BCC.
Yeah, 2 minutes remain in the game.
Get it going to the rack. Megan Parrish for three.
No.
Air ball. Man.
It's a good attempt trying to get it back in.
You don't need that hero ball right now. You got 2 minutes. You got basically 2 minutes left to play. Get something going to the basket. And now Bayhawks North Country just holding the basketball. From the elbow, the jumper no good by Diamante. Edwards stops and pops. No good. Deborah Banks with the basketball. Katia Luna for three. No good. The place is about to erupt.
The men really
in the
wanted
open
that
court,
to sink.
Tucker lays it up and in. What a turn of events.
That would have been huge if Luna was able to sink that.
I think BCC just running out of gas right now.
Rosenstiel, she jammed a finger.
Yeah, she jammed her finger.
That was a line drive right at her. Well, Rosenstiel biting the injury bug here and there now.
Man.
It looks like it's on her right hand or shooting hand.
Yeah, not good. It always no fun when you jam a finger.
No.
That thing just swells up, you can't bend it. It's not a fun thing. So 69-64, we'll keep it right here at Bishop Connolly High School. And what does BCC need to do to tie this game up, Craig? I mean, it's not an impossible lead. They need to get a good possession here and get points and make this a one-possession game.
Well, it's like you've been saying, just get good possessions, make this a closer game, and just stop giving the ball to North Country. They're beating themselves, really. North Country's not beating them. They're just causing turnovers. They're not making the shots they usually make. You know, they're just giving the ball right back to North Country.
But I think when BCC gets themselves in this position where they had a lead, they lost the lead, and now it's like a couple minutes left, it's like they start to panic a little bit. I think they start to try to do too much more than what they need to instead of just trying to figure it out and, make the little plays. They don't need to go for it all at once. You know, get a two-pointer here. Nice, to Shannon Rosenstiel. Oh, man, she had the look she wanted. Parrish, back out. Deborah Banks, jumper. No good. God, they had the looks. Parrish. That's what I'm talking about.
And Parrish just ran into a wall there and couldn't do anything, but she was able to pass it out.
It's going to be a foul shot game. Man, PCC had an excellent opportunity here.
This is no good as it's on Misa Edwards, and now she's in foul trouble.
Misa, Shannon Rodensteel, Deborah Banks all at four. 55 seconds left, so this game, not insurmountable.
No, they can still do it if they, like Santana we've seen, she hasn't been making a lot of foul shots. So she can miss this one, get a quick rebound, get that one in quick, get a quick turn. So it's not impossible.
That was a big free throw.
Still not impossible.
Now it's a two possession. That makes it a two possession game. And I guess it was still a two possession game, but still. Now they need a three. You need a three. You need something. If you have an easy bucket, you should take it. Nice drive.
Ooh. Megan Parrish, no regards for human life.
Wow. That was almost a best case scenario. I thought they were going to call a charge. That's why I kind of was waiting for it.
Yeah, she's going to the line. This really is best case scenario.
Do you try to miss it here? Do you try to miss? I guess not. Too much time left. 45 seconds left. Oh, can't get it.
Nope.
Oh, too bad they couldn't come up with that rebound. Now you get a foul.
Yeah, they did, and that's
going
to be
it. And that's going to be it for Rodensteel.
Yep. So, idiot contractor will be in the game.
It was going to be tough to win this one with Shannon Rodensteel. Now it's going to be even tougher without her. Idiot contractor goes in. Bridget Russ comes in for Williamson. Tucker calmly knocks it down. Boy, she really has come into this game and has done a whole lot of good for the Saints. Violation, that's big. So your PCC,
37 seconds
come out
left.
Here and get to come out here and get a relatively quick lay-in. Here comes the press. Edwards.
They got to do something.
In the lane, puts it up, gets it to go. Get to put the defensive pressure. Did you have to foul there?
That's going to be it for Edwards.
That stinks. Now you're down to four players. Misa, knowing that she has four, I'm not sure why she would make that foul. They didn't need you. A lot of time left. I don't know why you do that. You know you have four. Megan Parrish still has three, we presume. Katia Luna still has a couple fouls to give.
Deborah Banks only has one.
Yeah, so, I mean, call out to another teammate to foul, but, I mean, I still think you have enough time where you could have allowed the Saints to screw themselves, throw the ball away, try to get a steal. You know, I think they fouled too early into that possession, but we'll see what happens. Going to force Yvette Santana to make some free throws in some key moments. She's been kind of erratic from the line, so.
Yeah, now Bayhawks just have to hope for best case scenario, and that she misses both. They can get a quick rebound and put up a three at some point. But again, this four person offense is going to be really tough, and four person defense is going to be even tougher.
And yesterday, Craig, BCC faced the Bunker Hill team, and that's a big free throw right there.
Yeah,
that makes it a two-possession ball game.
Yeah,
BCC faced a Bunker Hill team that was down to their four players yesterday. So how ironic it is that they're playing with four now. Santana misses that one. Going to make a quick hoop. Still time. Parrish up ahead. Loses the basketball. Bad turnover there. That's a bad turnover. Man, BCC's had a lot of these games where they let it slip away, and there's been a few of them. You know, a couple other games I know on the schedule that they've had leads late and let them slip away in the last couple of minutes. So definitely going to be a learning tool for Coach Serge Moniz going forward.
Yep, Russ missed the first one.
If she misses this one, still in play. Missing them both. And BCC has the basketball, 72-68.
16 and a half left, two possession. Got to do this quick.
Need a bucket. Need some kind of a bucket. Need a quick bucket.
And that is not how they're going to do it.
Man, Megan Parrish with key turnovers here at the end. I can't. Right. Uncharacteristic of her.
Yep, you can put. And a foul for good measure.
I'm not sure what Megan was thinking on that pass. You know, if anything, she should have just took it herself. That was a bad play there, and that's going to seal BCC's fate.
Yeah, 6.6. I think you can turn off the lights, put this one to bed. Looks like North.
North Country has been very erratic from the line. Craig seals, she hits that one. Megan's going to shoot it. She's going to shoot it real quick.
She's going to put one up.
There it is. Three pointer. No good. Air ball. Wide right. And BCC will fall short in this one. So that's going to be it. That's going to be the final score on this Thursday night basketball. 73-68 is the final score from Bishop Connolly High School. The North Country Community College Saints are now 8-7. Bristol Community College drops to 6-10, still 5-6 in the conference. So who would you say our Bayhawks, our Lady Bayhawks player of the game is, if you had to give one to the Bayhawks?
I'd say, honestly, I think it might have been Kachi Luna, because she had a lot of three-pointers and some clutch two-pointers there, here and there. Megan Parrish is always a runner in the contention, though. She had some clear
I don't know if Luna was
moments.
This game. I don't know if Luna was this game, but if you want to give it to Kathy Alona, that's fine. I don't think she had enough plays. But on the other side, I would give it to Ramiria Tucker. She really asserted herself in that second half, and she was a big reason why North Country Community College walks out here a winner. So on Saturday, it's a doubleheader. January 21st, be looking for this on your dial. Springfield Technical Community College comes to Bishop Connolly High School, and the Bayhawks men and Bayhawks women will be in action. So for Craig Salvador, for David Cardozo and Craig Salvador, you've been watching Bayhawks basketball here on FBAR Media. The final score, 73-68, North Country wins.